Hi, you guys. So I wanted to film right now while I'm driving. I'm pretty good at writing things down, but it's better for me if I just kind of word vomit on you. The thing that I felt like I should share with you for this episode, in my Instagram, I have yet to naturally post about who I was before God. I was a mess. Like, I wasn't nice. Well, I mean, like, I was nice. I was always frustrated. I had so much anger and unforgiveness, and I always was negatively assuming, like, always. I got easily offended all the time. I didn't know how to deal with relationships, nor did I know really how to be a mom. I don't know who knows how to be a mom, but I wasn't a very nice mom. I'd snap at my husband. It was a lot. I don't know if you are able to relate, but if you can relate, even if in the smallest way, then this is for you. So I was walking, right? I felt like God asked me a question. Now, mind you, this question was specifically geared towards my marriage and who I was as a wife. However, he was able to explode that question in every area of my life, not just for my marriage. He was like, Genesis, who would you want to be in my husband's story? I was like, wait, what? What do you mean? God was like, well, if he had a chance to share about you and who you were in his life, would you rather be the nagging wife who always nagged him, which I was nagging him a lot, or would you rather be the wife who supported him, stood by him through the ups and downs, prayed for him, and encouraged him? Who do you want to be? And I was like, what are you saying? No, truth be told, it was a really, really hard, but very, like, just revelation type question for me. And it really shifted my perspective. I realized that we have the ability to choose how we would like to be towards people. And a lot of times we just kind of don't think about that. We kind of just react emotionally. We don't have to react to situations. We don't have to react to people. Can actually respond well. But I'm paraphrasing my journey because it goes way deeper than this. I want to just encourage you today to really ask yourself that hard question. Even if they may not be like reacting or responding well to you, doesn't give us the okay to not respond well to them. And if I do mess up, because we're human, okay, you're gonna mess up. Let me just say, it's gonna happen and that's okay. Basically, who do you want to be in their story? You know, like if they had a chance to share about you as a friend, a sister, a brother, whatever, what would you want them to say? Even as a mom was like, anytime now I get to a place where I'm yelling at them and I realize it has nothing to do with them, I'm just mad at something else, I have to take a step back and I have to apologize to my kids. I will apologize to my kids. Just challenge you to really just take a moment and really examine yourselves. Now, if you want to be a grumpy person who's mean, who belittles people, then, I mean, that's on you, right? We all have the ability to choose who we want to be. In the Bible, it actually says in John 10, 8 through 10, that the enemy comes to steal, kill, and destroy. God, Jesus, came so that we may have life and life more abundantly, or satisfying, rich life. I do believe that we don't give enough credit to the enemy. We kind of forget that he exists and we blame God for like just stuff that happens that's not good. It's a spiritual war. There is God who's for us and not against us, and then there's the enemy who actually does want to tear down your life. Let me just say, he doesn't like us, you know, especially because we were made in the image of God and we are loved so dearly by God that the enemy's like mad. That's actually the devil's scheme. He wants us to ignore him and place blame on God. I get it. Like, you know, for those of you who may not know God or maybe just learning about who God is, I get it. I've lived that life. I do believe a lot of us just forget about the enemy and forget that he's out to kill us and steal our joy and divide our family and to make it where we just blame others and blame God. God wants us to be free. internally so we can enjoy externally all the things that he's given us. And a lot of times when we do kind of allow ourselves, our minds to be renewed, and we start focusing on good things, his truth, we focus on things that aren't trying to steal our joy or steal our peace, you know, and we cling to that, you'll start to see that you will not get easily offended. You'll not get easily defensive. You'll have like an open heart towards people and who they are and like how we're all created beautifully and different. And it's okay if we have different opinions, and it's okay that we have different viewpoints and perspectives. I mean, how can we not? We all have different lives going on. That's the beauty of life, like coming together, all just different and yet the same. I encourage you to just really take the time. Examine your heart. Know that God is for you and not against you. Really pursue being the best version of who you are, and then continue forward. So I hope that helps in any way. Comment, spark a discussion, whatever you want to do. I totally love just doing this and just sharing with you, because God has honestly miraculously shifted my entire life. And so I really hope that these lessons that I'm learning can hopefully even just help you in a day, whatever, you know, like whatever it is God wants to do, I'm totally for it, because I do believe that he wants you to live a free, fully abundant and joy-filled, laughter, just life. And like I said, this is a paraphrase version of my life. Like, it's not always like pretty, but even in like the ugly, I just always try, do my best to ask God, what are you trying to teach me in this? How can I grow? How can I like have responded better? And ask him those questions, ask myself those hard questions, because I don't want to be the same person a year from now. I want to be a better version of myself. So yeah, with that, I hope you have an amazing day and just be blessed.